So making vegan milks are really, really easy. I mean, they sound complicated and people get scared of them, but it's really easy. Like, I make it every day for my son. Every night, actually, that's what he has before he goes to bed. So I make cashew milk, but it's about your choice. And so you just basically soak a handful of cashews or almonds or whatever it is that you want to make overnight. And then the next morning, you basically just blend it with water. Sometimes with almond milk, put a pinch of cinnamon and a pinch of Himalayan pink salt, and it just gives a really, you know, tasty edge. But it's really up to you. It's so simple, it's hilarious. Like, and now we have YouTube, Google. I mean, you can just check. There are a million people putting videos up there with amazing options and different recipes. So it's so easy. Please don't get frightened. Try it. I mean, you'll love it. Well, if you know you're going vegan for whatever reason, some people are concerned that, you know, why aren't you losing as much weight? Well, vegan food just means leaving out the animal products. So if you're like piling on the oil and eating a lot of fried food, a lot of junk food, that doesn't mean you're really going to keep the weight off, you know. So you have to really have a balanced diet. And if you do your smoothies and you eat balanced meals and you eat smaller portions and you have your vegetables and fruits, there's no way in hell that you'd put on weight. So another thing that I really love including in my diet is millets and pulses, dals. You know, as Indians, we eat a lot of mung or rajma or chana, and I love those especially. Like in our family, we make a lot of hummus, or we make a dry chana that's also like a nice snack. And there's soya nuggets, and there are like so many options that are actually there in Indian food. So we should just incorporate that, and that'll be really great for our health. Well, one of the first books I read on veganism was The Kind Diet by Alicia Silverstone. Also, Skinny Bitch was another good one. But there are, the China study is really, really amazing if you really want to know about the dairy industry, because that has scientists and actual doctors who've like researched the dairy industry and other things for really long time. So they have facts there which you can't deny. Besides books, I think there is a lot of information online. There are a lot of inspirational vegans as well who have YouTube channels and videos, and I follow a lot of them on Instagram myself. So there are recipes, and there's no shortage of information. So that cannot really be an excuse at all.